Hello everybody, welcome to today's YouTube tutorial, where today I'm going to be walking you through my brand new free thumbnail pack for Photoshop. Most creators these days use Photoshop, Canva, or something similar to create their thumbnails. I normally have a set of assets that I use for almost every single thumbnail that I make, so I ended up making myself a template file. And then I realized that my viewers could probably benefit from having something similar for their YouTube thumbnails. So hit the link in the description and that will bring you to the download page. Now, once you have downloaded the file, open up the PSD and you will be greeted with this title page for the thumbnail pack. You can start by hiding this title page at the top. If you click, there are some tips in here and this is how all of the layers work. There is the top folder and then there are sub layers underneath that that you can drop down right here and turn on and off with the little eyeball right there. So we have our tips and below that we have blicks or lens flares. Now these, we have 9 different lens flares that you can utilize, which I know everyone utilizes in their thumbnails. Now some of these aren't full size, as you can see. They are in a different layer style, which is called screen. So you can do one of two things. You can hit Command T and raise it to where it's, you know, it reaches the full edges. Or what you can do is you can go up to layer, adjustment, curves, and then you can actually make an S pattern here. What that will do is that will essentially lower the darks and brighten the highlights to where it kind of goes away because we've lowered our blacks and we've raised our highlights. We've made it more contrasty. This pack does have a few highlights, and one of the highlights in here is what's called screenshots. Now, if you turn on the layer for screenshots, you'll see that you're greeted with like a PayPal notification. Essentially, these are pre-made assets for you that you can hit a drop down on and kind of edit how you want. You have a PayPal notification, a Twitter message, a normal message, and then another message. And below that, for you finance people who are wanting to make finance thumbnails for how much money you've made or drop shipping and whatnot, there is a drop shipping dashboard where you can brag about your $580,000, all right? Some of us make that money. Some of us make the assets that go on the thumbnails of the people that make that money. The next one beneath that is the MrBeast effect. Now the MrBeast effect, you can see that it kind of smooths his face and it makes the colors correct on his skin and almost pop. And that's why his thumbnails really have a super high CTR, because they pop. They're super cool thumbnails. But if you drop down on this, you'll see that it's not just a import your photo and it has it. It's a lot of manual labor that goes into it. I will, however, show you, if you have Photoshop, how to get this basically automated for you. So I'm actually going to delete all of these layers real quick, other than the bottom layer. And then I'm going to, with this layer selected, go up to filter and then neutral filters. Now you guys may not be able to see this because of the way I'm recording this, but up at the top next to select and view, go to filter and then neutral filters. That will bring up this pop-up where it will scan for faces and allow you to apply these automated filters. And one of them is called skin smoothing. As you can see, by just hitting this on button, you can see it already smoothed out his skin a ton. And you have some parameters here that you can go back and forth on. And you can select the different faces if you have multiple people in your thumbnail. You can also turn that off and you can go to Smart Portrait. Smart Portrait basically allows you to affect the look of the facial expressions and how old the person is. So if we wanted to make him a bit happier and then also make him super old, we could do that. This, however, will take a little bit. As you can see down here at the bottom, it says processing in the cloud. So don't be alarmed when it doesn't happen immediately. This one didn't really do that well, actually. I mean, his face just kind of looks a little odd, but as you can see, if I turn off the facial age, he is a lot happier than normal, because normal looks like this. When you're done, you can hit okay on this guy. I'm going to hit cancel, that way it doesn't affect the template at all. I'm gonna turn off the MrBeast effect, and then we're gonna move down to the PNGs. In the dropdown, you have money, cars, water, fire, and nature. So you just have different PNGs of money and different things. You have them of cars. If you wanna just throw a BMW in your thumbnail, now you can. You also have water in this guy. Now I have utilized the water ones actually for a few different thumbnails for clients. And when you change up the blend modes, and if it's in the right context, it really does add to the photo a lot. I'm sure you guys will be interested in the fire. Now there are a bunch of high quality fire assets in here for you to use. There are 5 of them. And then also we have nature, which includes like sand and flowers and trees and things that you can put. I haven't really utilized these a lot, but they are in here in case you need them. The next layer that I want to show you guys are the arrows. Now the arrows are super fun. I really like them because I don't have to go sourcing them every time I need an arrow, which is always the worst when you're trying to pull something in and then it has that checkered box after it said it was a PNG. And so the cool thing about it is you can actually, Like let's take Aero 7. You can go into blend mode and stuff. These don't really have anything on them, but if you right click and go to blend mode, you can add a drop shadow, you can change the color, you can add bevel, and you can add a stroke, whatever you really want to add to these guys, you have the freedom to do it. And you don't have to go source them, which is like the best thing ever. Now, the next thing is another highlight of the pack that I really enjoy using, and that is the text styles. So the text styles are just preset titles that you can go in and use. I think these are all set to Gilroy in font, but if you don't have Gilroy, like it says that I don't, even though I do, you can highlight, hit replace, and then type in whatever you want, and then go in and choose a different font. A lot of people use the Babest New font for all of their thumbnails. And you have these like pre-made titles for you. That way you can utilize them in your thumbnails, which is pretty dope. They are high quality, so you can raise them up in size because they are text layers. And yeah, that's one of the highlights. I utilize these on every single thumbnail that I use. That's why you see that the text that I'm using in all of my thumbnails is about the same. Beneath the text styles is particles. Now, these particles, there are 11 of them. Some of them are more like in your face particles, and some of them are just like cool particles on the outside. So as you can see, there's some different like fire elements, some smoke elements, we have some sparks, we have some glowy orbs in here, and then I think there's one of them that's like a battle scene. Yeah, there you go. So for some of these, you may need to scale them up or turn the opacity down a little bit, but it is cool that these are all in here for you guys to use. Another thing that I have really needed in the past are emojis, and finding high quality emojis is difficult. So I have included an emoji pack in here. They are the iPhone ones. If you don't have an iPhone, then you can't use this. But these emojis I've needed in plenty of different cases. There's also backgrounds. Now the backgrounds I think are really cool because they are a good foundation to your thumbnail that you're making essentially. So you have water, you have sand, you have mountains, you have a grassy hill, which everybody uses the grassy hill. I've seen so many people use this PNG for different things, but I figured it being in here would be helpful for you guys. So then there are mountains, there's clouds, and then there's sky gradients as well. So you can add all these together and kind of layer them in. And so with the sky, the clouds, you can add like the grassy hill, and then you can add the MrBeast effect on it. And it's already starting to look like a thumbnail for a YouTube video, one of his YouTube videos. So anyway, that is, it's a cool thing that you can kind of like layer on and have a starting spot to go to. Because I know thumbnails just take a long time. And if you're starting from scratch every single time, it's just a very big creative drain for yourself. So having a template to start with is always a better option. And I'm hoping that you guys will enjoy this. If there are things in here that you would like to see added to the template, or if there are different effects that you think that we should be adding in here, let me know. And I am happy to go in and update this over and over and over again and make it the top best thumbnail pack ever. Just leave a comment down below or head to the Discord. If it's not working or you need assistance, me and my team will be there to help you out. Thank you guys so much for watching this tutorial, and I'll see you guys in the next video.